So in this lesson, we will see how we can make lists in LaTeX document. So LaTeX automatically numbers our sections and subsections, but if you want to make a list in any of the subsection or in a section or any other part of a document, then we have to use one of the few environments available to us. So what is an environment? Any part of a program which begins with this backslash begin at and ends at backslash n is an environment. So this document is an environment. It starts from begin document and it ends here. Similarly, there are three environments which we can use to make lists. So the first environment is itemize environment. So we will first practice this and then we will use other environments and we will see what options we have. So in order to use these list environments, which are itemize, and the second is called enumerate, and the third is called description. So these three environments are defined in this package, enumitem. So enum stands for enumerate and item stands for itemize. So we put a statement of use package. So this is a very simple program. We don't have any other text, just in order to explore these three environments. So we start the environment with begin itemize, then we put backslash item, means the first item in our list. Then we put anything, the first item in this list. Then again we put the backslash item, and then we put the second piece of text which we want as a second part in our list. And then the third one. So if I compile this first, so that you can see how it look like. And now you can see that this is our itemized list. So these are the three pieces of text which we want to make a list of. And itemize environments put a dot here, a bullet in front of these text lines. So we have a lot of options in LaTeX to customize this behavior of this itemized environment, and we will look into some of those options. So how to put any options here? So we can put an option here by putting these square brackets in front of this itemize, and then we can put many options. For example, if I want my items to be at a certain distance from left side, so I can put left margin equals, let's say, 3 inches. So this could be one of my option, left margin equals 3 inches. If I compile this program, so now you will see that my list has moved 3 inches from the left side of the text. So let us say that we don't want this dot, and instead of this dot we want to use, let's say, asterisk or a diamond. So how can we do that? So in order to do that, we put label here, put label equals, and then within the dollar sign we can put any math symbol. Not all, but most will work. Like for example, for asterisk we have backslash AST. So these are mathematical symbols. If you are using WinEdit, you can click on this math symbol here and you can select any of these. For example, if you click here, or if you want a star, so I'm using this one at the moment, this is AST. So if you you can click on this and it will insert this letters here. So similarly, you can use this star. So let's compile this document and we will see that how it looks like. So now you can see that we have asterisk here. So instead of that thing, we have no asterisk. So similarly, if you want this star, so you can just highlight this part here, this within the dollar sign, and you can click on this star. And you can recompile and it will insert star instead of this dot sign. So now we have star. So in this way, you can change any of these symbols which are available within this math symbols. For example, you can even put this arrow, or there are a lot of other arrows available here. If you look at here, these symbols are available. So this was one way to make lists. So the second environment is enumerate. So instead of itemize, we say enumerate. And if we compile now, you see, so we are using the label option here, but we don't want this to behave like that. So we remove this label option and we see the default behavior of this enumerate environment. So now you can see that by default, this environment ports 1 to 3 as numbers. These are called Arabic numbers, but you can change the way these numbers. For example, if instead of these you want ABC, so what you do, again we will use the label option here. So label equals backslash alphanumeric, so alpha and then asterisk. And now if I recompile this, it will put ABC here. So instead of Arabic numbers, we can use ABC. And if, for example, you want Roman numbers, so instead of this alpha, you can put, instead of this ALPH, you can put Roman and recompile it. Now it will put these 1, 2, 3 in lowercase Roman. So if you want uppercase Roman, you just replace this R with a capital R, and it will replace this lowercase Roman with the uppercase Roman numerics. So these are uppercase Roman numerics. So in this way, if you want Arabic explicitly, you can, by default it is Arabic, but if you want to write it, you can actually write like this, Arabic, and it will put the, and it will put these Arabic numbers, but this is by default, so you don't have to write it. So this was one way to make a list. Now, for example, that we have some text here, maybe two paragraph of text, and then we want to recontinue our list. We have three numbers, and then we want to recontinue from number four. So what we can do, we can just, I'm just copying this, but you will just duplicate this here. So I remove this label. I want to show you something. And instead of this, we put a resume. So now this is our fourth item, and this is our, let's say, fifth item, and this is our last item, last of the list. So now if I compile this, so now you can see that we have 1, 2, 3 there. Then we can write maybe 10 paragraph of text, and then we can continue our list from there. So we are resuming the numbering from where we left it before. So this is the way you can resume a list. So you just put a resume option here after this in the second environment. So this is the first enumerate environment. This is second. You put a resume environment. So let's say that we have a Roman style in here. So if we have a Roman style, so see what happens now. Now you see that we have Roman style here, but we don't have Roman style here because this is by default. We haven't given any option in the second part. So what you can do, instead of putting all this, you just put asterisk sign here after this resume, and you will compile it. And now you will see that it will follow the same numbering pattern which was before. So in this way, with this star option after the resume, this asterisk, you can actually continue with the same option which you have given in this label option in the beginning. So let's say that we want something a little bit further on the right side of after this item, some text. So what we can do, we can put subitem, and this is our text which is not the item. So this is not our item. This is just another text which we want to put. So how it looks like, just compile. And you can see that this is the text which we can put within any item. So this is not an item, which is a sub-item. So it will be indented from here, from this edge. It will be a little bit right side. So in this way, you can put any text here, and you can put any text in the middle, and you can still continue making this list. So there are a lot of options which you can have when making these lists. Now let's say that you want to put a box around these numberings. So first I convert this to, let's say, Arabic, or just the default option. And then I want to put a box around these numbers. So what I do, I just put a parenthesis around this. And then before this parenthesis, I can put F box. And by doing this, it will put a box. It will put a box around these numbers. So sometimes you want to put any numbers like this. So in this way, you have a lot of customization option with this list in LaTeX. So this is the second environment which we use for list. So these are the two main environments, itemize and enumerate. So if, for example, you want to have a list, a horizontal list, you don't want this vertical list. You want a horizontal list like 1, then 2, then 3 in a single line. For this, the first you can do is where you have put this command of use package, you just put some option of this package. So this package has one option of inline. So this is one of the option of this package. And if you put this option here, then what this package allows you, I just put this, copy this. So what this allows you to have an inline environment. And the inline environment is defined by an asterisk. And I don't want this resume here. So this is defined by a asterisk here and asterisk at the end. So when you put an asterisk, so it means this is an inline environment. And if you compile this now, you will see that now the list is a horizontal list. So the first item here, the fourth item, basically it's the first item, then the second item, then the third item. So this is a horizontal list here. You can individually assign these formatting to these items. So let me make another list. And this will not be horizontal list. I will remove this star. Just copy and paste. And I remove this star. And now I want all my items to be with different type of formatting. So for example, for the first item, I want a dash. So I can put this dash here. For the second item, I want an asterisk. So I can put within dollar sign AST. For the third item, I want a star. So within the dollar sign, I can put star, or you can insert from here. So now if I compile this, now as you can see, all my items now are marked with a different symbol. This is dash, this is asterisk, this is a star. So if you, for some reason, if you want to change this, so you can individually mark these labels. So these are some of the options available. And if these are the commonly we only need these type of options. There is no need for further fancy type of options. But if you want to learn more options, you can anytime see the documentation of this package. And but I think that I have covered most of the commonly used things. One thing we can also use, another option in this package is short labels. And if we use this option, so what we can do here is that instead of, for example, let me delete these things. And I want our uniform numbers here. So what this short label does is that instead of putting these labels like fbox and arabic and all this, so you can quickly tell the compiler that what type of formatting you want. So you can quickly say that, okay, just make it like this. You put a Roman letter, for example, and you just say, okay, just number like this. So if we compile this, so now you see that we just highlighted the first number, and the compiler has made the document like that. For example, if you want an arrow, so you select an arrow, good arrow from somewhere here. So let's say you want this arrow. So you just select this part within this and you select this arrow. So it will insert the symbol, and these symbols are available in any editor. It's not just only the WinEdit, but any other editor, these are available. So now if I compile, so it will put an arrow instead of the numbers or anything. So no, there are arrows here. So you can put whatever symbol you want, whatever number you want, whatever number style you want. And now we discuss the third environment, which is the description environment. So this environment also starts with begin description and description, and the format is a little different. Whatever you want to describe in detail. So for example, this is your short title of something you want to describe. So you describe that thing here, any definition or any subtitle or anything. This is your second subtitle or second definition of anything. This is your third one. So this anything inside this square bracket will be printed as a bold, and then you can explain it like here. So let me compile this here so you can see how it looks like. So here you can see that this is our description environment. So for example, if you have three options for anything, so you can put the title of the first option, then you describe it, the second you describe it, and third you can describe it. So these were the three main environments which we can use for making lists in LaTeX. So I hope that this will help you, and you can practice this with your own preferences and with your own style, whatever you want to do with this. And I think that I have covered a lot of options, and this is enough for normal use of LaTeX. And you have the option to look into the documentation of the package if you want to see further options in depth.